Adani is a big group which has interest across board in the energy sector, right from power, transmission, enterprise, ports, green energy, and Adani gas. We have just acquired 6 months back a power utility in Mumbai, serving 3 million customers in the city of Mumbai. So this is the recent acquisition, and I represent that organization. It's called Adani Electricity Mumbai Limited. You can see in the bottom most corner the Adani Electricity. It's a new acquisition which we have done. Adani as a group is the number one private thermal power player, the number one private transmission player, number one in ports, a leading renewable player, and number one city gas distribution. Currently, we got some more cities in the country for the power distribution to start with. Leading REL developer, leading one in edible oil. You must be having the edible oil from Adani Group, and the number one mine developer. Coming from Adani Group to the Adani Electricity Mumbai, the corporation we represent, is the current customer base of 24.45 lakh customers. That is about 2.5 million, and there are about 5 million customers who are changeover customers. So anybody who is from city of Mumbai knows what is the difference between a changeover and a switchover customer. This is the portfolio about the Adani Group, Adani Electricity Mumbai as a case. When we are speaking in a platform on a smart utility, sometimes I question myself, what is smart? There's somebody will say I am smart, somebody will say I am smarter, somebody will say I am smartest. So the journey starts from being a EDP player to a computerization to moving to automation, then from automation to digitization to digitalization. And the journey continues, and wherever you are in a journey, you will say whether I am smart, smarter, or smartest. In our organization, we call it as the digital utility service. We have around 10 use cases under which we are using these smart utilities working under, which we call in Hindi is called Das Kadam. And these are the some cases where use cases where we have actually worked on the utility service. These are five, and there are five more. I'll invite two of my fellow team members who will go into details of only two use cases, because Richard has said we have been cautioned to be within 8 minutes, so we'll only take only two use cases to...
Well, that's up to you. You still have 5 minutes and 19 seconds.
So we'll only take two use cases. We'll not go into detail of what we have done. So I'll start with the first use case on the emerging technologies on AI and ML. This is about the predict monthly bill the payment defaulter. I'll give it to Rajesh, who will go into detail of how we'll have done this on the platform.
Good afternoon, everyone. Actually, as introduced by Nitin sir, actually I will be taking you through the experience of implementing a bill payment defaulter use case in AEML. What is the business challenge we have? We have a collection efficiency, which is the important parameter in our utility business. We have to improve monthly collection efficiency by 5%. That is a clear mandate given by the business. Then we worked on how we can improve this collection efficiency by 5%. Obviously, it is related to the consumer payment behavior. So our solution approach was that we have a lot of data of consumer billing data, consumer payment data, then consumer interaction with our call center, consumer outage data. So a lot of data we have accumulated over last 15 years. So that is a rich source of data. Based on that, we can do the analysis. And we can predict the consumer behavior, whether the consumer will pay or not pay or default. So technology component we use open source technology, that is R and Python. Obviously, we are having a lot of choices to implement this technology, this use case. But we started with this open source technology because it is handy to be implemented immediately. The business benefit were very clear that we want to early predict the bill defaulters. Obviously, it is not going to improve our revenue, but obviously, it will minimize the workload on our recovery staff. Because once the consumer is defaulted, suppose the consumer is not paying within a specified time limit, then obviously we have to send a demand note within a 21 days, after 21 days. That demand note is nothing but we say it as a dunning notice. And after dunning notice, if the consumer is not paying, again we have to approach that consumer. So basically, a lot of man hours are invested in that, that we can save. So it is on that front, we worked on that. And see, I will be sharing the approach we implemented. We first use creation of this factor map. What is the factor map? We understand that this is a clean set, this is a new problem, and we want to study that. We don't know anything about that. Only we have a data, but we haven't looked to the data. So we took the black box approach. That means what we need to predict the defaulter. So these are the factors we need to you know, to predict the defaulters. What are those factors? It could be demographic, it could be consumer interaction related to the complaints, it could be payment data. So all the data which we need, we jotted down all the data, and we try to find out whether that data is available with our any system. Obviously, we have our enterprise-wide systems implemented in AEML. We have a CRM, we have a billing system, customer system, we have an outage management system, then we have a GIS system, all those systems. So we try to find out all those data, we try to find out what is the source of that data, and then we map. So these are the static parameters we jotted down. Initially, we only took a few parameters because since this is an open source data, so we are not going to integrate with this enterprise system. Later on, we decided to integrate with this enterprise system. Then we find out the derived parameters. So these derived parameters are very much important for building a model. But before building the model, we want to understand what is the pattern hidden in this data. So we did lot of EDA, exploratory data analysis. This exploratory data analysis gives us lot of insight. This is still, we are not going into the machine learning aspect. But this is important to, this is an important input to prepare a machine learning model. We did lot of this exploratory analysis, trend, default, then month-wise pattern. Last month, the same customer defaulted. This year, which month the consumer defaulted. So all those patterns we decided. Then we built up, then we segmented those consumers. We carried out a cluster analysis using K-means algorithm. And then that is the input to the model building. So the model was built using various algorithms for various segments. We built the model. So we use various algorithms. We use boosted tree, then decision tree. So a lot of algorithms were used as per, and we found out the best fit algorithm, and accordingly we implemented the model. Initially, we got the accuracy of 75 to 80%. That was encouraging to us, and it helped us to go in a big bang way. So we are going to implement it for all the 3 million consumers, and we'll be using an enterprise-wide data lake, or you can say data big data platform, and we are going to implement in a big way. So that is our experience of implementing this use case using open source data. Obviously, what we learned from this, that it is possible to implement this use case with open source, but we need a scalable platform, and we are going to implement that. And second thing is that data quality, which drives this accuracy of this prediction. So we have to work on that aspect. So the 70-30% efforts are required, 30% on model building side and 70% on data cleansing side or data preparation side. So that is our responsibility, and we are going to work on that. So that's it from my side that I shared on this use case. Over to Santosh.
Yeah. Thank you very much. It was a very exciting presentation, and actually showing how you can use an existing incredible number of data, and you've been showing, of course, it would take much more time to explain how to do this, how to succeed making, milking at maximum this amount of data. But I think it was very clear that you've been running a lot of expertise data analysis there, and it's a very impressive attempt for utilities, and I think this is a complementing a lot the presentation we had up to now. Thank you very much. Please.